Perfect, thank you.
If you really want enlightenment, then just lighten up.
Do you ever have those days where you just kind of get it? And you just kind of have such a clarity and an awakefulness. You just have this insight. Just like, you know, I just got hit by a really great, huge, cold wave. Just washed over you. Today was one of those days. Oh, I'm getting goosebumps right now. Because I've just had so many different awarenesses over and over today. You know, it's like you hear something a million times over and over again, but it doesn't really sink in until, you know, just that moment, just that time. When you are able to sit there and look at yourself and be like, wow, yeah, okay, that makes sense now. Today was one of those times for me, and something that I had happen. I was on an Empower Hour call, and I was listening to Vic, and he was just sharing with such clarity and profundity, you know, how he's gone from, you know, point A to point B. And so often, everyone is looking for, you know, the direct shot, you know, give me the secret. How did you do it? How did you do it? How did you do it? Come on, give me the secret. What traffic generation did you use? What leads were you getting? Blah, 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 blah. You know, they were coming at it from a completely wrong angle. I feel like so many people are so disconnected from their own guidance system. They're always constantly looking for the secret out there. They're always constantly looking for the guidance out there. But that's not what this is about. That's not what success is about. Success is fundamentally about tapping into your own connection with the divine, your own connection with your subconscious mind, your unconscious mind, your own resources. And today it was such a profound click for me. That's why there aren't people out there telling you exactly what to do from point A to point B. It's because you need to tap into your own resources and develop your own self and your own skills, because that's 80% of it. The specific strategies are irrelevant, because none of them are going to work for you unless you have developed the right mindset to get there. That mindset has to do with, you know, being able to withstand challenges, being able to be resilient, to come back from adversity without, you know, calling it quits and caving and completely succumbing to other people's negative opinions. That's why so much of what I do is not so much about, you know, how to do all these things with your business, blah, 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 blah. I'm not giving you all of these strategies and tools, because those are plentiful, those are abundant. what I am trying to help you do is to get right up here. Because then the path will be made clear for you. The path, you will walk on it. The issues you do encounter, you can just overcome them. They're not obstacles in the sense that they are mountains that you can't overcome. You know, it's something that is very different than the way that we're so used to looking at the world. You know, people have always told you that since you were very young, I'm sure, follow your dreams, follow your heart, and if you weren't that lucky, I'm sure you've heard it before repeated on the television sets, right? You know, our whole economy is built around people, is based around people just trying to, you know, pursue their dreams, the American dream, you know, that kind of thing. But you don't need to be living other people's dreams. You can create your own. You can follow your own. You don't have to go out there and, you know, work the 9-to-5 and, you know, have 2.1 kids and, you know, marry at 30 and do the whole routinized thing. You can just create your own dreams. And you know how you do that? You use your imagination. You use visualization. You read books, you listen to audios, you listen to other people who have had incredible stories, or those triumphing stories where they're rags to riches, whatever it is that you want to do. It doesn't necessarily have to be money, but for people who wanted to travel, you know, the idea is for you to have a raised belief level, and that raised belief level comes when you start, you know, repeating these ideas over and over to yourself, because when your subconscious actually takes them as instruction, starts to reprogram your mind, and allows you to actually start believing them. And that's when amazing things happen. You know, for me personally, I had a really interesting idea with this. Like, I came across the idea of affirmations and, you know, subconscious reprogramming a long time ago. And I realized that when I started telling myself new ways of being, I actually operated in those ways over a consistent period of time. You know, I used to repeat to myself, it was kind of silly, I mean, I was back in high school, you know, but I was going to be a famous artist one day, that I was going to do really great artwork, and people were going to know my name by my artwork. And you know, while I'm not like a super famous artist yet or anything like that, I still have created pretty amazing paintings. You know, like, much beyond what I would have if had I not been, you know, telling myself that I can paint really well. I also had a very interesting experience with that when I was, you know, going to college. Probably I was 19 years old or something like that. And I remember standing in the line to be put in my placement tests for the community college that I was going to at the time, and repeating to myself, "I am a math wizard. I am a math wizard." And all the while that I was repeating this to myself, you know, I was actually believing it. And I walked out of there and I placed into like a high calculus class. And I hadn't taken math since 11th grade. And there was no reason for me to really like think that I was like all that great in math. I failed algebra when I was like in 8th grade. So it's just, there's these ways that we talk to ourselves, and when we start changing that mechanism, we start getting a different outcome. And of course we're going to face, you know, adversity and try to have to overcome some of these obstacles that get in our way, like our doubt systems and our belief systems and all of the other crazy crap that comes up for us, like our relatives and the negativity that comes around from, you know, naysayers and doubters who haven't reached their dreams and just want to destroy yours because it'll make them feel better. It's honestly kind of sad and messed up, because there are many bitter people out there who, just because they are miserable, want to make everyone else miserable too. When you have these beliefs in yourself, and you have these, you know, these higher esteems in yourself based on, you know, just continual repetition of this belief to yourself, as well as seeing the evidence that proven to you that, you know, you are going somewhere, that you are achieving things, that you are moving in the right direction, you know, that builds on itself, and you're moving towards that. You know, I had an experience just last year where I wanted to go to Hawaii, and I had no idea how I was going to do it. At this time, I wasn't really employed, I wasn't really, you know, doing anything with my business or anything. I really had no idea what I was doing on the internet, to be honest. And I had this idea in my mind that I really wanted to go to Hawaii, because I really felt that was what I needed to do at that point in my life, that would be what moved me forward. I had hopped on the Woofing website and I had found the perfect place that I wanted to go. You know, Roshani's Kapuka Malahia, this amazing place. She, you know, she was helping people deprogram themselves and helping them shatter some of these belief systems that were really getting in their way of living a truly fulfilling life. And, you know, I saw this and I was just like, oh, I need to go there. Because all of my life I've been very interested in personal development. And I saw this as an opportunity of a lifetime. Now, this was the perfect time of my life to be able to go and to be able to experience Hawaii, as well as being able to start shifting some of these mind patterns of mine so I can move forward full steam ahead. And the most amazing thing happened. Within 24 hours, I had the money to go both ways, both there and back. I had no idea how that money was going to come. And because I had that belief that it was going to happen, it did. The same happened when I went to Chicago just in April. I had no idea how that was going to happen. I had just started online. I had just barely started. I had no money. I didn't really know what I was going to do. You know, but it's because I was following these tuggings of my heart, because I was following these visions I had set out for myself, because I had that guidance system, that belief in myself that, you know, I can follow my path. It doesn't have to make perfect sense to me right now, but if I continue putting one step in front of the other, one foot in front of the other, I will get somewhere and it will be good. If I follow my instincts, if I follow my intuition. It's a skill to develop that trust in yourself, and everything in society teaches us to not trust ourselves. And everything in society teaches us to rely on other people, and to rely on the professionals, and to rely on our teachers and our parents for all of our systematic guidance, you know, for everything that we need in life. But I'm here to tell you that you don't need to do that. and that you have a very well-equipped internal guidance system, that through proper development and proper nurturing with daily audios, reading books, and getting around the right people who are all connected to their guidance systems, amazing things start to happen. You can't put the strategy seeking in front of the personal development. It doesn't work. It does not work. I'm trying to tell everyone that. I see so many people in all of these different network marketing groups, you know, out there, you know, free recruits, and you know, you can tell they're beginners, and you know, $10 per recruit, and blah 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 blah, and they have no idea what they're doing because they have just been taught and told, you know, this is how you get leads. But you see themselves running in circles and they have no idea what they're doing. And it's so sad because they're so disconnected. They're so hungry for the next dollar. They're so eager to just get more money. But they have no idea how to relate to people. They have no idea how to make an actual connection with a person and actually help them. This is how people make honest fortunes. This is how people make, you know, healthy fortunes. There's people out there who have made really unhealthy fortunes, and those people are the ones that everyone hates. You know, the fat cats, the banksters, the people who made their fortunes by stealing and lying to people. But it is entirely possible to make a healthy fortune that, you know, is made and created out of good nature and service to others. So, if you're interested in more about this vehicle, which is all about, you know, learning how to be ethical and how to actually market online and not try to scam people or rip people off or, you know, leave people in the dark or leave people in the lurch, whatever you've seen with online marketing before, this is nothing like that. This is about actually connecting with people and actually helping them. And actually making money. So if you're interested in that, click the link below. If you're not, I'm not offended. No, I only want people who are wanting to work with me. I'm not interested in people who I have to convince. And yeah, let's just talk, okay? If I can help you out in any way, just let me know. Alright, this is Katarina Edwards, and I'm signing out.